persistent monsoon that moans in the night, its breath a searing flame from the bowels of the underworld, carries on its breast an urgent plea from the quintillions of lost souls that roam the shadow world of that dark dimension. And this message vibrates, serpentine-like, up a roya across desolate wastelands, through the oily waters of the amphibian-infested swamps, over the crest of the ice-capped peaks, and down to the blasted hearth to shriek in our attentive audio receptacles. That the hour for nightmare is once again at hand. And what a succulent morsel of good fortune that we were ever at the ready for such a thing, video feeds. For a real blood-icer, bone-brittler, the cinema is about to flicker to life on your television screens. It is called The Frozen Ghost. And guess who stars in it? Morris? No. Baylor? No. But I'll give you a little hint. If a thing is frozen, it is bound to be stiff. Now, who is the stiffest actor in the universe? Huh? Right! Lon Chaney Jr., the most horrible horror thespian ever to don grease paint of unearthly hue and plastics of unnatural born. By the warlocks of Wapsahatchee, what are you doing, Rodney? You rude roustabout! Rodney, turn that blasted thing down. You hear me? What is this? Rodney, have you capitulated to the adolescent philosophy of rebellion without cause? Have you? Well, it serves you well enough, Rodney. You're getting so blasted show-offish about everything. Huh. Now, you just plop your young flanks down on that chair a minute, fresh sprig. It's time you and I had a monster-to-monster talk. Straight from the shoulder, so to speak. Anatomically, that is. Huh. Well, let me confide in you, good fool. Has ever a bond of amigoship ever known such continual assault and strain wrought by this callow-clogged, vacillating taste? Oh, it is indeed a caution, and it requires the most assiduous of direction to lead him from these extremist tangents. Well, while I map my campaign, you troops bivouac by your TV sets to perceive the first act of The Frozen Ghost.